Hello students, good morning to one another. Okay, up to now we have discussed about the conversion of wolfing into epoxides, right? In which, so we have discussed about parasites, right? And next, another important reagent, that is, or another important topic, that is surface asymmetric epoxidation. So this is also very important, right? But here the epoxidation taking place to the double bond whenever it is having allylic alcohol, right? Which means that when allylic alcohols are present, so then only we can apply surface asymmetric epoxidation. The name surface is a chemist name, right? So that's why here we are going to discuss about surface asymmetric epoxidation. And the condition what we have to remember is that, so that is, the compound should be allylic alcohols, right? So that is the condition for the surface epoxidation. So for example, suppose we are having allylic alcohols, right? And allylic alcohols are oxidized to epoxides, right? For example, suppose here, let me take, this is the some allylic alcohol here, right? So whenever we are using surface reagent, right, then so the double bond is converted to epoxide again. But what is the reagent here? So what type of reagents we have to use here, right? And here the reagent for this conversion is, right, the first one we need to use tertiary butyl peroxide, right? First one is tertiary butyl peroxide, and along with that we have to use plus or minus DEP. So DEP means that diethyl tartarate. So diethyl tartarate. And its structure, so nothing but, so this is COOC2H5 and COOC2H5, H O H. So diethyl, and tartarate. So this is called as plus or minus diethyl. So it is having two forms, plus form and so minus form also, right? So along with that, we need to take, titanium tetra proboxide, IOPR in short, you can simply write tetra proboxide. So titanium tetra proboxide is the reagent, right? So this is also we have to use, right? And whenever we are using this, right, so we are just getting epoxide, but what is happening? So we are getting asymmetric epoxide, which means that, so asymmetric epoxidation means that, so it is coming under asymmetric synthesis. Asymmetric synthesis means that we are telling about the stereochemistry, right? So we are getting the epoxide, so whether it is in the below the plane or it is in the above the plane. What type of stereochemistry we will discuss about? Whether the epoxide will come into the, so below the plane or coming to the above the plane. So that is the concept of surface asymmetric epoxidation. We are not getting a normal epoxide. This is a normal epoxide, just it is present in the in plane. But so you can generate the epoxide either above the plane. Suppose just let it some plane, and either above the plane or below the plane, just right. So if you say like that, then it is called as asymmetric epoxidation. So that's why the synthesis is called as here asymmetric synthesis, right? And here, to understand that, so we have to use, these are the reagents, right, for the conversion of allylic alcohol.
So that should be asymmetric. So but the type of asymmetric is decided by the these reagents, especially decided by the plus reagent. In fact, this is playing a key role in giving asymmetric epoxidation. Remember, so this is very, very important. It is deciding. Okay, so what type of stereochemistry is coming for the epoxide is only decided by the plus DAT or minus DAT. Right, right. Next, let us see faster. Suppose one more point we need to remember here. How it is deciding here? Right? How it is deciding? Let us take by take. And here, suppose if you use plus DAT. Suppose if you are taking plus DAT, right? Whenever we are using plus DAT, so plus DAT directs the incoming or the epoxide, or it is delivering the oxygen, okay, from the below the plane, right? So whenever we use plus DAT, delivered oxygen from below the plane. This is very, very important. So it is delivering epoxide, okay, or it is delivering oxygen from the below the plane, or simply you get S epoxy, or simply you get epoxy alcohol. Epoxy alcohol. This is the point we have to use. Suppose if you use minus DAT, so then what is happening? So delivered oxygen from the above the plane, from the above the plane, or you simply get R epoxy alcohol. So this is very, very important, right? We need to remember this one, right? And here, so plus DAT or minus DAT just acting like a ligands. They are acting like a ligands, right? And whenever we are using tertiary butyl peroxide and tetra isopropoxide, right? For example, if you take titanium, so tetra isopropoxide, and here titanium metal is also playing a key role, and it is acting like a mediator, right? So on titanium metal, so DAT is adsorbed, tertiary butyl peroxide is adsorbed, right? Remember, suppose this is a titanium metal, and on titanium metal, so DAT is absorbed, okay? So plus DAT, okay, or minus DAT, okay, minus DAT. So this is plus DAT, this is minus DAT, right? Minus DAT. And on titanium metal, what is happening? So DAT first adsorbed on that. Whenever tertiary butyl peroxide, so TBuOOH is connected with the titanium. So here, plus DAT directing the oxygen from the tertiary butyl peroxide from the below the plane. Whenever we use minus DAT, then the tertiary butyl peroxide delivers the oxygen from the above the plane. So that's why here the deciding factor is DAT, whether it is plus form or it is minus form. These two are first absorbed on the titanium metal, and then they are making some process of delivering oxygen into the olefin. So that's why, for example, suppose if you take an aryl alcohol like this. Suppose here I am taking some aryl alcohol like this. So then what is happening here? So whenever I use tertiary butyl peroxide, that is TBuOOH, and then along with that, suppose here let me use plus DAT. Suppose I am using plus DAT, and at the same time, suppose I am using titanium tetra isopropyl.
PR 4 times, right?
So then here epoxidation takes place. Here epoxidation takes place, but this epoxidation is coming from the biliary plane. So irrespective of the plane of the OH,
that is whether the OH group present in the above plane or present in the below the plane.
So, but here the epoxidation formation depending only on the DE plus DT or minus DE. Since here we have used plus DT, that's why it is delivering oxygen from the below the plane. So, this is also called as below the plane epoxide or simply S epoxy alcohol. So this is the S epoxy alcohol. In the same manner, suppose if I use tertiary butyl peroxide, that is TBuOOH, and then along with that, suppose now this time I am changing the and then I am using again, these two are quite common, but here we can change the direction of the DET only. So when you change the direction of the DET, whether it is plus or minus, right, then only so we get then only the resulting stereochemistry is changing, right? And here again I am using titanium tetrapropoxide 4 times. So then what is happening? Whenever I use minus DT, then the epoxidation will be directed so only from the above the plane. So this is the point we have to remember, right? So by doing epoxidation, right? So here, so minus DT delivering epoxidation from the above the plane, and here plus DT delivering epoxidation from the below the plane. Or simply, so this is called as S epoxy alcohol, and this is called as R epoxy alcohol. So these are the points we need to remember, right? So very, very important, not only for the examination point of view, but also for the competitive examination. So we will have this kind of applications from these synthesis, right? Next, for example, let us see one more example for this. So that is, and here I am taking compound, but the compound containing two types of double bonds here, right? And here this is the double bond, or you can also take like this, right? So simply, this is the double bond, and this is right, and here this is allylic carbon, right? This is allylic carbon. At allylic carbon we are having OH, so that's why we are getting allylic alcohol, right? And whenever I use again, so tetrabutyl peroxide is quite common, and if I use plus DET, and if I use again titanium tetraisopropoxide, right? So then what is the product here? Here, so we can also observe one thing here. So that is, even though we are having two double bonds, but this is allylic double bond, this is normal double bond. So wherever we are taking two double bonds, but we know that from Sarclash, so only allylic alcohols undergo epoxidation without disturbing the other double bonds. So the compound may contain more number of double bonds, but wherever allylic double bond is present, so allylic alcohols are present, there only epoxidation takes place. Even the epoxidation is asymmetric. Means, so we may get R or we may get S epoxy alcohols. So based on the DET, right? So that's why here, so whenever we are using, but if you, unlike that, suppose if you have taken a normal parasite, suppose MCPBA, if you take MCPBA, only this double bond is going to react faster. So without affecting alanine double bond, with MCPBA, so this is the more reactive double bond. Why? Because, and here this is more electron rich component, and it requires a neutrophilic double bond. So that's why, so whenever we are using MCPBA only, so this double bond undergo oxidation, but in this case we are using only salt plus reagent, so that's why, so this double bond, that is the alanic double bond, is going to oxidize faster. So that's why here the product we can write is, so that is, right, so that is, and here, so we are having the epoxidation plus DET directing the epoxy oxygen from the below the plane, so without disturbing the other double bond, in the same manner, if you can use, okay, minus DET, if you can use minus DET, again you will get, the epoxidation, so that is from above the plane, so this is above the plane epoxide, without disturbing the other double bond. So this is called as shortest isometric epoxidation, right? Next topic. So up to now, so we have concluded the surface isometric epoxidation, and also some more reagents are present to convert, to convert olefin into epoxidation. Up to now we have discussed about the conversion of olefin into epoxidation. So what are the reagents? We have used peracets, and we have used hydrogen peroxide, and we also have so many reagents like I2NaHCO3, this is also used to, especially for, so gamma delta unsaturated compounds, right? For example, suppose if you take, double bond like this, okay, and here, so this is alpha, beta, and C double bond O, OH, right? Alpha, beta, gamma, delta unsaturation. Suppose if you take gamma delta unsaturated carboxylic acid, so these are converted to epoxides, right? So then we have to use I2NaHCO3, this is also. So HOCl, so this is also used to convert, so alkyl to epoxide. And one more reason, dioxazanes, for example, so dioxazanes can also use it to, oxidize alkenes into epoxide. So dioxazanes structure, right, dioxazanes, just like it seems to be, dioxazanes cyclopropane structure like this, right? And here, this is, some groups like, trichlorocarbon and trichloromethyl groups are there. So this is called as the dioxazane structure. So by using these reagents, not only MCPBA, not only hydrogen peroxide, not only surface isometric epoxidation, but we can also use these reagents to convert the olefin into epoxidation. But here I am not going to complete details of this reagent due to some lack of time. So but after coming from the holidays after online sessions, so then when you come back, then I can deliver, I can explain everything about this. But here, so briefly I am explaining all these things, but I have covered more and more important topics, right? I'm just covering more and more important topics, so regarding the fourth semester oxidation topic, right? So these are the very important topics, right? Next, coming to the, so I told one more point, when I start the conversion of olefin into epoxide, not only this one. So olefins are also converted. If you do oxidation, the first initially you will get the epoxidation. Unlike that, so without epoxidation, we also get alcohols also. You can convert olefins into alcohol. 1, 2 diodes. This 1, 2 diodes. So wherever we are using oxidizing reagent, particular oxidizing reagent here, you can convert olefin into cis diodes, or you can convert olefins into trans diodes. Okay, right? So trans 1, 2 diode also, right? With the help of some suitable reagent, so we can get cis diode or trans diodes, right? So what are the reagents we need to use, right? Up to now we have discussed about what type of reagents we have to use to convert olefin into epoxide. Now we are going to discuss about, okay, so what type of reagents that we need to use to convert olefin into cis diodes or trans diodes. So there are mainly four types of reagents are present. So in oxidation to convert olefin into diodes, those are, one is called as Prevost reagent, right? So Prevost reagent, right? This is especially giving trans diodes. What is giving it? So it is giving only trans diodes, right? And second one is Woodward reagent. And second one is Woodward reagent. So this is especially giving, this is especially giving cis diodes, right? This is especially giving cis diodes. And one more, okay, that is potassium permanganate, that is KMnO4. Okay, this is also used to convert olefin into cis diodes, right? So this is also giving cis diodes. And one more reagent, that is osmium tetroxide, OSO4. So this is also giving cis diodes. This is also giving cis diodes. So these are the main reagents that we need to use to convert olefin into 1, 2 diodes. So let us first discuss one by one. First, let me talk about, okay, Prevost reagent. So the first one is Prevost reagent, right? And Prevost reagent, right? So what is Prevost reagent? So Prevost is the scientist name, and the reagent is, what type of reagent we have to use. So whether it is Prevost reagent or Woodward reagent, so what is the difference between these two? The reagent is quite common, but so in case of Prevost reagent, we should not use water. So that's why this reagent is also called as dry reagent, you know. So this is also called as dry reagent. So why we are calling this dry reagent? Because here we don't need to use any water. We should not use any water. Without using water, we are getting, okay, so trans diodes. But if we use water, that is called as wet oxidation. That is called as wet oxidation, right? And here that wet oxidation, but this is called as dry oxidation. So dry oxidation, this is called as dry oxidation. So that's why here, okay, so this is also called as dry oxidation. So why we are calling dry oxidation? Because we should not use water. Simply, so what I am talking, without water, remember, without water we need to proceed this, right? And here, right? And the reagent is, so the reagent is some silver acetate in the presence of iodine. Silver acetate in the presence of iodine without water, it is Prevost reagent. Silver acetate with iodine, with water, it is Woodward reagent, right? And he modified, okay, for getting cis diodes, he modified just only one change, that is, he used only water. He used only water for getting cis diodes, but he didn't use any water. So that's why he got trans diodes. Let us see, okay, how we are getting that. So by taking one example, let me explain. For example, suppose here I am just taking some cyclic olefin, cyclohexene. Okay, whenever I can use silver acetate with the help of iodine, then cyclic hexene is converted to, okay, cis diodes. So that is like this. Okay, cis diodes, that is like this, right? So we are getting cis diodes. Okay, both are in same plane, above the plane here, right? Let us see its mechanism. So how did he got, so this kind of product, so by using this, right? And here, so let us study by taking mechanism, right? So again, take the starting material, cyclic olefin, right?
slightly olefin, and here. So and here in this first iodine is going to react, right? We know that iodine is the right. We can write II. So this is delta plus, this is delta minus. So if you break this, what you are getting? I plus and I minus. Now, so since olefin is nucleophile and nucleophile will react with the acrophile, so that's why here olefin is reacting with the I plus and it is forming iodonium ion. It is forming iodonium ion. So simply, so this is delta plus, delta minus. So it reacting with the delta minus. So and it's going around electrons again, bonding with the iodine. So that's why here. So whenever we use iodine, so initially what we are getting iodonium ion formation. And here the iodonium ion formation taking place from the below the plane, from the below the plane, right? So it approaches the olefin is okay. Iodine approaches the compound from the below the plane. So this is above the plane and this is below the plane. So iodine approaches from the below the plane. So then we get iodonium ion. This is called as iodonium ion, right? And here, so in this case, after that, and here RCOO aging means that. So the next reaction is RCOO aging means that RCOO minus Ag plus. If it is dissociated, so if it is undergo dissociation, then we get so RCOO minus here and Ag plus here. So now, so this is acting as a nucleophile. This is acting as a nucleophile. So that's why here, and whenever we use, okay, whenever we are using, so R silver state. So RCOO minus means that RC double bond O minus. So it is attacking on iodonium ion. It is attacking on iodonium ion, right? And here, take a look here. So here the iodonium ion present in the below the plane. So that's why. So and here there is some steel crowding, okay, to the attack of state anion. So that's why here the state anion approaches the iodonium ion from the above the plane. Why it is approaching from the above the plane? Because already in below the plane some iodonium ion is present. So that's why it is approaching from the below the plane. Suppose this is iodonium ion already present here, and this is okay. So RCOO minus approaching from the above the plane. So that's why here, okay. So stereochemistry is very important, right? And here after that, so we can form. After that we can form iodine here from the below the plane here iodine ion. So this plane will not be changed, but here so this bond is broken up and we are getting I here, and here we are getting above the plane OC double bond OR. OC double bond OR. Now what is happening? So iodine will be eliminated. So iodine will be departed whenever the lone pair of electrons on the keto oxygen atom will attack on this carbon, on the carbon which is bearing iodine, on the carbon which is bearing iodine, right? So that's why here. So and here the entire group is present in the above the plane. So and here what is happening? In this what is happening? It is just acting like a nucleophile. Nucleophile attacking from the back side and front side iodine will be eliminated. So that's why here, okay, that's why here what is happening? So from its plane it is eliminating iodine. So that's why here this O is coming from the above plane, and this concept is called as neighboring group participation. This is neighboring group participation, and neighboring group participation means that just like SN2, just like SN2. So from back side it is attacking, and front side iodine will be departed. So that's why here what is the resulting compound? What is the resulting product? And here, so oxygen is from the above the plane, and oxygen is attached to carbon here, and carbon is attached to some R, and so carbon is attached to some R, and so O and double bond O, right? So and O is attacking with its lone pair of electron, it is forming a bond here. So since there are three bonds around oxygen atom, are the lone pair of electrons lost by oxygen atom, that's why we represent with the symbol positive. Okay, right? So that's why. after that what is happening, right? And here, sorry, so wherever we are using reverse reagent, we get trans diodes, we get only trans diodes, right? We get only, sorry for the mistake, okay, we get only trans diodes here, right? And here now one mole of another mole of, so with this what is happening, another mole of sulfur escape anion attacking like this, right? And here, so another mole of RCOO minus is attacking, okay, is attacking like this. Now it is attacking like this, it is attacking like this, right? Now this is approaching the compound from the below plane. Why? Because already in above the plane some steel chlorine is present, right? You take a look here, this is above the plane. So in above the plane already, okay, the atoms are existed, but so from the below the plane there is no steel chlorine, so that's why here this is approaching, okay, or this is approaching from the below the plane, okay, this is approaching from the below the plane. So are you understanding? So this is approaching from the below the plane, right? So don't get any confusion, right? So already in above the plane we have steel chlorine, so that's why the next acetyl anion is approaching or is attacking this molecule from the below the plane. Why? Because to nullify the positive charge, here this bond is broken up, here we get positive charge. So on this positive charge O minus is attacking, on this positive charge O minus is attacking. So that's why here the resulting compound is, okay, right? And above the plane O and C double bond O R, and from the below the plane what we are having O and C double bond O R, O C double bond O R. So this is the product, so after second molecule is attacking on the compound, right? So then after this what we are doing, just do hydrolysis in the presence of basic medium. So here I am doing basic medium hydrolysis, so this is called as saponification, very important. So finally, so what we are doing, this step is called as saponification. Whenever saponification means that basic medium hydrolysis. So whenever we are doing basic medium hydrolysis, so then we get the desired product, that is what we want. So we want the trans diode from the previous reagent. Okay, so here final step we are using water, right? Not initially we did not use any water. So up to here the reaction is completed. So later on we are doing hydrolysis. We are adding hydrolysis. So we should not consider. But initially we should not use any water. If we use water, that is Woodward reagent, right? So after one mole, if we can use water, that is Woodward reagent, right? But here we are using final. So forgetting final step only. So hydrolysis taking place. So that's why here after breaking, hydrolysis means that here this bond is broken up, and oxygen will take hydrogen and C double bond will take OH here, and here also, okay, oxygen taking hydrogen and C double bond with this break is taking OH here. So finally, so the product is in above the plane O is converted to OH, and in below the plane again O is converted to OH. After, so with the expulsion of 2 moles of RCOO, this is the byproduct, this is the main product, right? So that is the importance of Prevost reagent. What is Prevost reagent? So Prevost reagent especially used to get dry oxidation. Why we are calling dry oxidation? We should not use any water, so in the reaction, so maybe you can use at the final step you can use water, but initially we don't have to use any water. So that's why it is called as dry oxidation. So three group Prevost the stereochemistry is very important. We are getting trans diodes, and the name of this one, so trans 1 comma, so trans 1 comma 2 diodes, trans 1 comma 2 diodes. So this is the importance of Prevost BSMT. Thank you, students. I hope you can understand the concept of Prevost and the concept of surplus asymmetric epoxidation in this video. In the next video, so I would like to discuss about Woodward reagent, and again some more reagents also present. Those are KMR4 and osmium tetroxide reagents are present. Okay, thank you.